Okay, let us continue today's lecture. So, patella, it is a wooden plank used for smoothening the soil and crushing the weeds. It is also used for baking clods, packing and leveling the plowed soil and to remove the weeds. Basically, this is a animal-driven leveler with combination of weeding. It is made of wooden plank with a number of carved steel hooks bolted to a steel angled section, which is fixed to the rear side of the plank, you can say here. The cutting edge levels and pegs the soil, and the carved hooks, these are the carved hooks, uproots the weeds and collects the weeds so that it can be removed from the field. This is the, you can say, secondary leveler, secondary implement, tillage implement. Where actually weeding is very important in this case. So, this is a combination of leveling and weeding. Then, leveling board or bullock drum leveling. Generally, wooden boards of length 2 meter, width around 40 centimeter and thickness about 30 centimeter provided with side wings, hitching rails and handles are used as leveling and which is hitched to the animals and pole. You can see here, there is a handles are there. Generally, the farmer or the behind the plow, the operator stands on the leveling board so that the weight is given to the leveler. The blade scrapes soil from the elevated places and the soil is moved to the places where there is depression and the soil is released to the depression to fill the soil. Thus, the leveling is done by this leveler. Generally, it can be used in the paddy field after puddling. The tailboard is used to control the leveling depth. Then the tractor-drawn leveler. So it is a tractor-mounted implement. So basically controlled by tractor hydraulics and three-point linkage. It consists of heat system, replaceable cutting blade with sharp edge, and a curved plate with side wings. Curved plate is called the bucket. You can see this one is called the bucket. The bucket looks like this. The curved edge. And this is the blade. During the operation, the blade digs into the soil and extra soil is collected in the bucket. This bucket collects the soil and subsequently it is released in the depressions of the field. The angle of the pitch and pitch of the leveler is adjustable by the lever generally controlled by the three-point linkage and hydraulic system so that it can be angled left or right or reversed for back filling. So, filling the soil is collected and filled into the depressions. Land rollers, which are also called the pulverizers. Land rollers or pulverizers are tools used for further preparation of the seed bed, basically crushing the clods. It is used to finish preparing the seed bed by thoroughly pulverizing and firming the loose soil, little compacting, so that there will be no any large space or pockets in the soil. It generally presses the upper soil down against the subsoil, making continuous seed bed in which moisture is conserved and given to the roots of the plants as it needed. You can see here, this is disc type, so compacted disc type and having little projections are corrugated. These wheels are clod crusher. The V-shaped ruler or pulverizer, which consists of a number of wheels or sections arranged on a shaft. So, similar to that pulverizer. So, this surface of the ruler forms a kind of corrugation, which is called the corrugated ruler. So these are corrugated rollers similar to that one. When it rolls, it pulverizes, packs, levels, cultivates and mulches the soil. Multi-purpose. Coming to secondary tillage implement for rice. Since rice is very water intensive crop and the soil has to be made very paste form or saturated soil is generally used. The soil should be soft. It should be mixed with the soil, water properly. Generally, cage wheels are used in the tractor for this puddling purpose or for the rice plantation. Before the plantation, the seed bed has to be prepared. The cage wheels are made of cast iron or iron wheels or loud wheels, you can say, with L angles. Here you can say this L type angles on the side of the wheel. So this is sometimes the width of the full cage wheel is around 1 meter. This is around 1 meter sometimes, and that of the half cage wheel is so half this side one and this other side one. Sometimes it is fully covered by the tire is covered. Instead of tire also the cage wheel is used. This is in this case the cage wheel churns the soil and mixes the with water, soil water, and this mud is prepared. So it is called the puddling. Then puddlers are used for churning the soil, which is the active tillage tool. See, in this case, instead of tire, directly cage wheels are used. This is a traction wheel here also, or transportation wheel in this case. But a puddler is used for churning the soil with standing water while preparing fields for paddy transplanting. So puddlers are secondary tillage tool, and sometimes it is also used for soft soil, primary and secondary both. This is generally puddling is done on the water, standing water on the field around 5 to 10 centimeter of depth. Different type of puddlers, namely straight blade, helical blade, pedal type, cage wheel type puddlers are used, which is at active tillage tool. The power is taken from the PTO. Let us discuss animal done puddler first. Generally, the animal done puddler consists of 4 to 6 number of 0.6 meter long blade, radial arms to hold the blades, axle, goose bearing, frame, hitching braces, handles, etc. The frame consists of front, rear and side pieces. Puddling unit consists of blades made of mild steel. The blades are easily fixed on the radial arms. If you see this one, this is the frame. Frame is this one. Then the puddling unit is this one. This is the puddling unit. The radial arms on the puddling unit, radially they are placed. And this holds the blades in the position. So blades are there on the radial arms. And these are made of mild steel blades. Axle is this one. Here is the axle. Axle made of mild steel around 25 millimeter diameter. And beam. You can see here, this one is the beam, or this one is beam. The beam is made of wood generally and suitably placed in the frame with the help of washer, and the other end is to the it is connected to the yoke of the bullocks. This is the yoke and this is the beam, and here actually there is leveler is also attached to that animal done puddler. So here actually this is very small width, around 1 meter, 1 to 1.5 meter, and the cellule depth is done. So many times you have to puddle the soil so that the desired puddling can be achieved. The weight of the puddler is around 30 to 40 kg. During the puddling, these blades rotate and puddle the soil. Coming to the rotary tiller, or you can say power tiller. The rotary tiller or rotary cultivator sometimes is called, is widely considered as the most important implement as it provides fine degree of soil pulverization for the rice cultivation before folding. It is directly mounted on the to the tractor or power tiller and is operated. You can see, so the benefits of the rotary tiller are effectively pulverize the soil, which ensures good plant growth, cuts and mix the stubbles and roots with the soil, levels the field. So these are the basic benefits of the rotary tiller. Coming to the components of rotary tiller, includes rotor fitted with blades. Number of blades varies from 36 to 48 numbers. It's having gearbox, then power shaft, sprocket, chain drive, universal joint, leveling, everything is there. So if you see, the rotary cultivator is having the PTO powered, and it is attached to the 3-point hitching points. You can see here, this is the PTO shaft connected. So there is a gearbox, so that power is given, and this is the shaft, and this is the chain and sprocket arrangement is there. This is universal joint, and the leveling body there, back, and these are the, then 3-point linkage will be there. So 1, 2, 3, whatever. So 3-point linkage provision is there. The power from the tractor engine is transmitted to the rotary tiller for the PTO shaft. Leveling wood is attached at the rear side. This for the leveling of the soil. Generally, two number of adjustable brackets are provided on each of the either side of the unit for controlling the depth. So this is the adjustable bracket or gauge wheel. The rotor is generally operated at 180 to 200 RPM. It's very important. So it cuts the slice repeatedly and pulverizes the soil. And number of blades already discussed, that 36 to 48 numbers on the periphery of this axis is the blades. Generally, different type of blades are used for the rotary tiller. Basically, L type blades are used, mostly used. It works well in pressy conditions, more effective in cutting weeds, and but less pulverization is done by this L type of blade. But if you twisted blade, where actually deep tillage is needed on relatively clean grounds, but clogging and wrapping of trusses on the tires, tines and shafts needs to be frequent cleaning because of this. So twisted blade, this one, twisted blade. So here actually the clogging is very frequent. Straight blade, generally mulching and other things where actually it is done, not much disturbance of the soil where mulching is needed. Generally the straight blade are used in the rotary tiller. Then coming to the plowing of land. The plowing of land separates the top layer of the soil into furrow slices. The furrows are turned sideways and inverted to a varying degree depending upon the type of the plow being used. It is primary tillage operation generally, which is performed to settle soil uniformly with partial or complete soil inversion. There are few important terms are used in during the plowing, which can be defined like this. First of all, during plowing, furrow is the most frequent term we use. It is a trench formed by an implement in the soil during the field operation. Like this, this is the furrow or trench, you can say. Then furrow slice, the mass of the soil cut, lifted and thrown to one side of the furrow is called the furrow slice. Like this, this is the furrow slice. Furrow and furrow slice are similar. The trench is called the furrow, and the slice which is deposited in the side of the furrow is called the furrow slice. Then furrow wall is generally undisturbed soil. surface by the side of the furrow. So whatever the soil is undisturbed when cutting or during climbing is called the furrow wall. So this is the furrow wall. So by the side of that the soil is cut. Then crown. Crown is the tough portion of the turned furrow slice called the crown. So the furrow slice, the top of that one is called the crown of the furrow. Then this is called the back furrow. Back furrow is a raised ridge left at the center of the strip of land when plowing is started from the center to side is called the back furrow. So back furrow is generally rare, but it is generally seen when raised ridge is left when the plowing is done from center to side. We will see what is center to side and side to center. Generally, when the plowing is started at the middle of the field, furrow is collected across the field, and while returning trip, another furrow slice is left over the first furrow. This is the raised ridge, which is named as back furrow, just like this. You can see. So, two furrow slices will be deposited, one of, on another one. This is called the back furrow. Coming to the dead furrow. So, dead furrow is an open trench left in between two adjacent strips of land after finishing the plowing is. So, if since two are one on another one, so here you can see. So, one patch will be there or open trench will be there like this. That will be in this case both sides cut, one half of this one cut to this side and other one deposit the other side. So, therefore, this will be a open trench that is called the dead furrow. So, you basically you should not be confused about dead furrow and back furrow. So, back furrow you can see here one after another. So, it is a more height, it is the less height. So, dead furrow is the lowest one and highest one is the back furrow. It's the simple. Then, headland. What is headland? So, headland is while plowing with a tractor to turn. So, during turning, so if we, this is a field, so tractor has to take the turn one after another. So, a unplowed land is required at the head of the, both end of the land, that is called the held end. At the end of the each trough, the plow is lifted until the tractor is, and the plow have a turn. And in position to start the return trip. So basically, if you see here starting, it moves forward trip, then it will take the back turn. So this area, so you need to take the turn and it again come to this way. Generally, this one is done when you are using one way plow. So, basically, anyway, you need to return or take the turn. The head length is about generally 6 meter to 2 or 3 bottom tractor plow. If 3 or 4 bottom plow is used, generally 3 meter to 6 meter is used for, generally 6 meter is used the head length. So, this is called the head length, which is unplowed land left at the each end of the plow. Coming to the method of plowing, first of all, it is side to center or it is called the casting method. Whenever a plow walks around a strip of unplowed land, it is called to be casting. So, plowing of a field by casting is called the side to center. So, this is side to center. Here actually the start point is side and finally it ends at the middle here. Whenever it starts from the side and gradually it comes to the center, it walks around the unplowed land and the soil is dispersed to the side. Therefore, it is called the casting. Then another method of plowing is called the gathering, where actually this is done the center to side. So you can see here it is starting from the center, then gradually it goes and it works around the strip of plowed land in this case, because the center is starting, so center is the round one, so it is plowed land and it ends at the side. It is called the gathering. Why it's called the gathering? Because the soil is generally, if you start from here, then all the soil should be thrown to the towards center. So therefore it's called the soil is gathering. If the slope is towards the middle, then middle one soil is gathered to the middle, so it's called the gathering. The reverse is casting. So basically the soil is thrown outside center or towards the side, therefore it's called the casting method. But if we don't need to either cast or gather, then we have to use the continuous method. So continuous method, or it's called the one way plowing. So this is two way plowing, because here the moldable plow or plow throws the soil to one side, and in return back it also have the different side. But in this case what happens, you have to change the plow bottom when you take the turn. Therefore continuously plowing, or sometimes it goes round and round plowing to the center. Here actually there is no need to have the slope or making gathering or casting. Generally it is used by two way plow, reversible plow, and this practice is done on hilly terrains or base terraces. Hope you understand everything. Please like and subscribe to my channel.